Gonna chat about stuff and what 2016's got in store for you and me and just the world.
Is it on?
It's always on, so, baby. I'm gonna stand by us if that's okay, because otherwise it's just
annoying. I like the hum.
Do you like the hum? I'll leave the hum.
You need the hum,
just the life. So, the hubble bubble.
I'm in America yesterday and now I'm in England today, and before I left, somebody called me and said, "Are you going to Andertons?" And I went, "Why?" He says, "We watch all their videos." I'm like, "Oh my God.
Do you even have the internet in
America?" The captain has made it to America.
It's my favorite place. You know, it's...
Whoa. You live here and your favorite place is America?
Well, I love coming back to England, but if you want to go somewhere to be inspired about playing the guitar, it's tough not to go to the States, isn't it?
Yeah, for me, coming here is really inspiring.
Oh, that's crazy.
Really inspiring. As a matter of fact, I like finding wonderful old gear. I actually saw three Benson Echo wrecks yesterday.
Really?
It's like, I've never even seen one, much less three in one
spot. Is that as you go up the stairs in the back of...
No?
Because I know at the back of Hank's, as you go up the stairs, they've got these kind of crazy early Japanese guitars where the pickups aren't called pickups. The switch says microphone one, microphone two, microphone three.
I can't wait to see
and all that kind of crazy. You can really see kind of how... I mean, these must be... early 70s, I suppose, you know, just as the Japanese are kind of going, oh, perhaps we should make some guitars as well, you know.
First time I went to Japan, there were Marshall clones there, and one they were called Mad Shells and Marsnalls. A Marsnall is they would break the H off, and it was an N, right? And a Mad Shell. And I regret to this day not buying the little, it was a little teeny stack, single 12, you know, a Mad Shell and a Marsnall. I've gone back to Japan 20 times. I've never seen them again. It was just, but that's the where it started. They, you know.
Nice. Well, so 2016. Can't believe that you. It was like a year ago that you were last here.
You've got my shirt.
I've got your shirt.
How did you get my shirt?
Well,
that's my shirt.
Because
I want you guys to know that's my shirt. How did you get my shirt? You asked me for it.
Well, I kind of. We've had a running gag at the NAMM show. The very first thing that I see you, every time I see you for the last 5 or 6 years, the first thing I say is, "Nice shirt."
Yeah.
So this year, you mid-show, you just strip off and just give me the shirt.
Well, it wasn't that bad. I didn't strip
down. Why not? I mean, literally.
I had a T-shirt on. That's not fair.
There was he did the whole show in his wife beater T-shirt like that, just a white one with like gravy.
That's
stains
bullshit.
Down the front of it.
That's bullshit. A wife beater?
Is that what you call them over there? You know, like a vest.
That's like you cursing in American slang. It's like me saying dogs, bollocks, and everything else. It just doesn't sound right. A wife beater.
It is, with like Stella Artois dripped.
You know why they call them that? Because the guys that dress that way used to beat their wives.
Yeah, I know.
It's terrible.
I think we're allowed. Yeah, you're probably right.
With gravy stains on it?
Yeah, that's a good look. It's a good look. Trust me. No, anyway, so
yourself in the mirror.
So
I
don't beat my wife. Not on a weekend, only on the weekends. Anyway. I don't beat my wife.
Oh, man, that sounded like a Trump debate. That was really bad.
Oh, we can't get political. We can't get political. But
I'm not saying whether I'm for him or against him. What I'm saying is this sounded like him in a debate.
Yeah, that's very true. That's very
true. They accused him of having small hands in the debate the other day. And he goes, "Not only are my hands not small, but that implies something else. And you wouldn't be disappointed." On national TV,
I know.
Looking for the person to run our country. It went that low.
I know. It's.
Has that ever happened in English politics that it went that low?
I'm just trying to think. I mean, no. I think it's the truth.
I
mean, we have probably the most personality-driven politics of my lifetime at the moment over here, and it's not even on the same planet
it's
as your.
Turned into a reality it,
it's,
TV yeah,
it's just.
Show.
It's just. I've seen some great Saturday Night Live clips about Donald Trump. Anyway, look, I appreciate that it's a free world. You can vote for whoever you like to.
Did you see?
Just as long as you keep playing the guitar.
Did you see Tina Fey play Sarah Palin 4 years ago?
Yes.
You know what she said? She walked by the camera. She said, "Would you please finish this election so I don't have to do this anymore?" Unbelievable.
So, come on. We've got to keep this on track before this becomes a party political broadcast for Hillary Clinton or whoever, Bernie Saunders.
No, it's not going to be free. I'm not going to go there.
Okay.
I'm not going
there. No, let's not go there.
I'm not going there. But where I will go is you guys have done really well with our guitars here recently. I can't tell you how much I appreciate it. And
it's gone from like a niche high-end brand for us to our third biggest brand. It's the staple. You know, it's like, honestly and truthfully.
What's number one? If we're number three, what's number
one? Well, let's give you a clue. One of them begins with G and one begins with F, and they vie for one and two.
And how do I fix that so I get in there? There are stores in America where we're number two, and there's a couple where we're number one.
And I can believe that because, I mean, to be totally honest with you, I can completely believe that. You know, I mean, I guess, you know, we're full line for both G and F. And look, honestly, man, the numbers we've done on PRS, it's probably 10 times the size that it was 6 or 7 years ago.
And what is the return rate from your customers? Do they...
Oh, it's. I mean, in the UK, it's. I don't know how the same as it is in the US, but everybody in the UK, if you buy over the internet, you have a legal right to return anything you like. And in the store, we just have a, I don't even know what we call it, like a goodwill gesture. So we don't ask anything that any customer buys. If they don't like it, they can just return it. So it's like no arguments.
After how many years?
Oh, no, not years. 30 days you get, 30 days. And I don't know what PRS return rates are. I mean, certainly on
in America,
USA, it'll
very,
be zero.
Very, very low.
Yeah. If you don't like, I think that's the thing with guitars, isn't it? There's no such thing as the best guitar or the worst guitar. There's only the guitar for you. So I guess there's always going to be a small percentage of people who buy anything and just go, nah, you know what, it wasn't what I thought it would be. But no, PRS is minuscule, minuscule. So I'm very pleased about that.
So on Friday mornings, all our managers get in a room and we open cases just like your customers and you do.
Yeah.
And we grade everything.
Mm-hmm.
And I was asking Jez when we started this trip, what other companies do that? And I'm not hearing that other companies like get in a room on once a week and go through random guitars that are being shipped, right?
No,
so,
I'd be surprised.
Is there an excitement when the guitar comes in and you open the case?
Or? Always, always. Well, we're very lucky. Jez, who, you know, I've got to say is...
Jez is an event. He's not a human being, he's an event.
No, we get looked after by Jez probably better than anybody else that comes in.
Is Jez male or female?
Well, the Jez I know is male. Yeah, okay. Do you know a different? Maybe you probably spend a bit more time with him than I do.
I've been in a car with him for
months. Oh my God! Okay, but so anything that's American is all handpicked by the guys in the store. So if we say, look, we need to order 3 or 4 more custom 22s or whatever it is, Jez will bring like 15 of them down. We get to go through and
why don't you take all 15?
Well, if you put me on the spot there.
Yeah,
don't
you? I know.
If we had a bigger
store,
that's true. So look, I thought that we'd grab 4 guitars that are kind of either new or revisited for 2016. And you can tell me what, you know, did you get your little Chinese New Year cookie at the beginning of the year? And what did it say in it? You're going to have a great year, Paul. You must do something to the S2 standard, do some new colours, put a funky scratch plate on it. Tell me about this one first.
You just told me that it's going to be a great year, but I have to come out with new colors.
But this is a cool color.
What's wrong with that color?
No, this is a new color for 2016.
I understand.
But I love this color, and I've never seen like the sort of, well, I say 26, back end of 2015. So this is S2 with a slightly different kind of scratch plate on it in a, what do you call this color? Do you call this Pelham blue, or do you just go metallic blue or something?
You know, there's a whole team of wickedly good artists that work on these guitars, and they have these names for the colors, and I've decided to quit getting in the middle
of it. Oh, really? So it is what it is.
I mean, it looks like a beautiful powder metallic blue to me.
I love it.
What the name of the color is, I don't know. Jez knows. What color is that, Jez?
Ice Blue Fire Mist.
Ice Blue Fire Mist.
See, I told you, wickedly
wow,
good with
that
colors.
That is wicked.
Yeah.
And I must admit, so S2, tell me about, because S2's been in the line for 5 years now?
Yeah.
So what, you know, kind of S2 popularity going up? You got plans for that? Where?
Well, so there are several silos of business. We have our private stocks.
Yeah.
That's a private stock shirt.
It is.
Then we have Artist Pack, and then our core guitars. And then it comes down to CEs, which I'm playing, and I was just noticing. This thing just won't stop. So you have CEs, and then S2s, and then we have our SE line. And they're made in Maryland, they're made in America, and they're about two-fifths the price of one of our normal guitars, but they're made by the same people on the same line. And when people take tours, they go, I can't believe the S2s are made right alongside the other ones.
Yeah.
Are you selling S2s? That's going
yeah,
on?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, S2, I think it's an interesting split, really, because it's the plainer looking S2s seem to be more popular for us. So it's almost like the opposite.
Anti curly maple.
Yeah.
That's great.
So it's like people like the, you know, the cherry red sort of just mahogany top, you know, things like a Myra
So they put stickers on them? What do they do when they
get them? I don't think people are really bashing them up or anything like that. I don't think there's like a relic thing going on. I just think it's an understatement. You know, it's like it's a great guitar with, I mean, this is the intonation on these guitars is always so good. It amazes me just how different, because yours has quite a lot brighter,
isn't
it?
Another chord.
So, S2.
It took me years to figure out.
This is a complete Joe Bonamassa ripoff. So instead of, he'll go. Actually, no, he doesn't. He puts his little finger so. Side break there. What's the main difference between, so when we're going from S2, so CE has come back.
Yeah, it's back.
It's back.
This guitar sounds good.
I know.
I can't tell you how nice that is to come in to another country, sit down, get handed one that I shipped, and then it sounds recording ready right off the bat. What's wrong with that? And it didn't need a repairman.
My recollection of, see, the last time we were doing CE, I would have been a wee whippersnapper, probably in my 20s. And I think my perception of CE first time round was it was just the way to do a more affordable version of custom. And second time round, I'm just going, do you know what? I don't think it is all about being a more affordable version of a custom anymore.
All
it's
right.
about just
I'll
being
bite.
A new
what
flavor.
Is it?
It's just a new flavor of guitar. You know, it's a different feeling, sounding.
Well, because of the wide, thin neck and the maple and all that, it doesn't just feel like a less expensive custom. It feels like a different guitar. I
yeah.
would agree with that. This guitar sounds good.
Different pickups in S2 and CE?
Yeah.
Yeah, so I guess just a slightly different kind of tone.
I think these are 85-15s, and they sound just clear and
yeah.
musical and sweet.
What's the thinking behind the does 85-15
it's
mean
the
something?
Guitar, it's the pickup we would have made in 1985 had we known.
Right.
And it was finally made in 2015, that's where the name came from.
Oh, that's cool, that's cool. So look, so S2 I love, and S2 is a popular line. S2, to be honest, I think I've said this to you before. I've always been a bit of a fan of kind of being a bit more understated with my guitars. So I do like S2. McCarty is probably the one in the US line that I rather like.
So we're going to try two other guitars, neither of which I've plugged in. Same pickups as the other guitar, but it's got a little bit more warmth than the low end. Do you hear it? And this has a maple neck on it. So is this something that you did special?
Yeah, so that's why I thought we'd bring these two out. So what I'm holding here is essentially the 2016 Spec Custom 24. So with the 85-15
yeah.
pickups, but without the bound neck and the different bird inlays. And what you've got is, I rather fell in love with a limited run of guitars that you did, I don't know, middle to end of last year, where the necks are all a flame maple neck. So yeah, if you flip that one over to show camera, we've got, 20 of these, something like that, in different colors and stains. So I was just thinking,
So
you've got a mahogany neck on
it. The serial number on this is 219056. This is a wonderful guitar.
But so what do you think of when you're going from...
Did I said the name on a video, will that help sell it?
Oh, you
I'm
never know.
I'm telling you, this guitar,
you
this
never
is
know.
A
this will be the one that we've got left right at the end.
So if it's left at the end of the year, call me, I'll buy it. This is a wonderful guitar. That's one thing you might not know about me.
Go on then.
I swear to God, I take a look at it from a musician's point of view. If I play a guitar that I adore and it's made by somebody else, I want it.
Yeah.
If it's made by us, I want it. If it's made by somebody else and I don't like it, I don't want it. Made by us and I didn't like it, I don't want it. And, you know, it's when I walked in here, there was an old Strat sitting in the back. First thing I grabbed, give me that guitar, I want to play it, right? I'm sorry, I'm a musician first. And if there was somebody making guitars and I liked them better than what we made, it would be very hard for me. But this is a really nice guitar. The thing we've gotten better at is the sustain.
When you say you've got better, what have you learned then to... You know, what are the composite things that go into just making a guitar try and sustain more?
Well, if you have a guitar made in 1985 and you send it back to us, we can make it sustain like this. It's not the guitar itself that has shifted that much. It's much more the tuning pegs and the nut and the bridge and the way it's attached. All that stuff has gotten better and better and better and better and better.
Yeah.
The nut material is loaded with bronze powder. So
wow.
Yeah, because weight, you imagine weight would make a difference. So not most, but a lot of nuts and a lot of guitars are made out of the same thing you hook your toilet to your septic tank with. I mean, I'm not sure that's musical instrument material, but this stuff is a special compound and it made all the guitars sound better.
Yeah.
I mean, look, if you make this out of rubber,
yeah,
or you make it out of bone, you would imagine you hear a difference, right?
Yes.
Okay. If you glued it on or you didn't glue it on, you'd imagine you'd hear a difference, right? If look, a lot of people don't think that the tuning pegs make a difference on a guitar, but if you take a $375,000 Les Paul and you stick Grovers on it, it's now worth $250. Those tuning pegs are worth minus $125,000.
Yeah.
Okay, therefore it must make a difference, but you put a five-way switch in an old Strat, doesn't make it, the price doesn't change.
Yeah.
So there are things that we think make the guitars better in history, and there are things we don't, and I'm telling you that anything that touches the strings, the tuning pegs, the nut, the bridge, the way it's all attached makes a huge difference.
Yeah.
Because the guitar string's got no weight, and so anything that is touching it is going to have an effect on that.
It's a great tone.
All right.
I love it.
So, we have yapped at Americans. We have yapped at Englishmen. We have yapped at Frenchmen. It's going out all over the world, right?
It will do, absolutely.
So, what do you want to cover? Because basically, you told me nothing about what you wanted covered.
No, well, I don't like.
I knew I wanted to tease you about being captain.
Yes.
About your shirt.
Absolutely.
About a lot of things, but
I don't really. To be honest with you, what I like about guitars. In fact, what I like the most about the job that I have is I don't really think we have to do anything to sell guitars as such. You know, the job I had before I had this, when I failed all my exams at school and my dad kind of kicked me out and said, let go, you know, I sold photocopiers for a year. That is selling. That is going, knock, 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 I know you don't want to see me. Can I try and sell you a new photocopier? Being thrown out of 99 places out of 100. Guitars, I just love the fact that all we do is we go, I love this guitar, and I love that guitar, and I love this pedal, and I love that pedal, and I love that amplifier, and I'm not so sure about that amplifier, but I love this one. You know, all just stuff like you would talk if you were in a bar with a friend of yours who all played guitar, and people want to listen, and
if
people
want
to join in.
If I had the photocopier experience,
yeah.
I would love it as much as you too, because it'd be like comparison shopping. I'd never want to go back. That makes complete sense.
Yeah. So there's I don't even like the term. The only thing that we do that is selling is the transaction. The bit where you give me some money and I give you a guitar. I guess that's a sale. But that's it. But so yeah. So I don't really want to. I think.
Do you get grinders in this country? Do you know what a grinder is?
Sadly, there is an iPhone app called Grindr that Jez will tell you about. I suspect you'll massively regret asking me this question.
Oh, I'm going to ask. A grinder in America is a guy that comes in and all he wants to do is beat you up on the price and tell you he can get a better price somewhere else and just grind the hell out of you. And usually it's not true.
Yeah.
And he just grind you. And there's an app called Grindr. You want to explain this? Is this a worldwide app or is this just an English app?
I'm not. Do you know what? I'm not even telling you.
Tell me. I want to know all about
this.
Grindr.
Has to be edited out. So.
So you're saying a guy goes on Grindr and
it
compares all the prices.
No. Grindr in the UK on the app is really different.
So tell me about it. I want to know all about Grindr. Go.
If you're a chap of a certain persuasion, let's say you bat for the other side.
Yeah.
And you want to meet other guys who bat for the other side.
No.
You know, for a good time. As opposed to any long-lasting, meaningful relationship.
That's terrible. I mean, it's fine for them. I'm sorry. It's just, I like the other hydraulics. I like innies. I'm not into Audis. But whatever. Did I just trump it? I think I just trumped it.
I think we did. So there you go.
Look, tell me, is it really Grindr?
It's really called Grindr. And yeah, there's you know, whatever. It's look, hey man, we're in the music industry. Everything goes in this industry. So whatever, you know, but yeah, that's so yeah, a Grindr, someone using Grindr in America is clearly trying to achieve something very different to someone using Grindr in the UK. Over here, if you were a guy that just wanted to beat me up about pricing, as opposed to beat me up about anything else, then yeah.
You know, I had a rock star once when I was over here.
You were, sorry?
Very, very famous rock star. And he goes, wait a minute, I gotta get a fag to suck on. And I'm like, oh my God, you can't say that. Oh, you wanted to smoke a cigarette. I didn't know. Guys have some strange... You have some strange sayings, I'm telling you.
We come up with all the best ones. Anyway.
The dog's bollocks. You want to explain that to the Americans?
The dog's bollocks is a term that we use. Is it? not rhyming slang, is it? Dog's bollocks. It's just an old saying to, if something's really cool.
It's the dog's balls.
Yeah, I mean, that's probably a bit old. That was really, really popular.
And then you shorten it to bollocks.
That's the bollocks, yeah, absolutely. So we would say, you know, that, Paul, is the bollocks.
The bollocks, okay.
Yeah. Which in America, I guess, might go down completely differently. I don't know.
They would kind of know if you said that's the bollocks. They go, oh, it's cool. They would kind of know what that meant, but it's not their term. It's like watching a German swear in English.
Yes.
It wasn't his first language, you know. I'm sorry, for me to try to go after somebody saying, you know, English curse words, you know, bloody this or whatever, it just wouldn't come out of my mouth right. It's not my first language, this kind of slang, right? But I'm telling you, if you're in Texas...
What's going to happen in Texas? I've never been to Texas.
Boy, let me tell you. You going to crank or what? And we got terms over there. We got shit that happens in the South. Oh, you can't even. If you tried it, it would sound like me doing an English accent, sound like Dick Van Dyke.
Ah, from Mary Poppins. No,
it's
absolutely
not good. It would be really bad.
I don't know. Do you know what? These conversations, we should just do a different channel for when you and I get together. I don't even think we need guitars for these kind of chats, do we? We should just talk about the cultural differences between UK and the US.
Will you do me a favor? I really want, at the end of this video, to go around Andertons and do a real quick walk around of the store and show everybody the inventory you have, the staff that you have, all the lines that you have, how clean the place is, how much you would want to, you know, sit down and play through one of those amps or one of those guitars or whatever. This is a very, very good store or great store, but it's also run like a top by people who care about guitars.
It's a family thing, isn't it? I'm very kind of you to say that.
You stole my shirt.
I think we've done a terrible job of telling people why they should go and check out the PRS line, but a great job of making out what a wonderful human being you are. Really? Okay.
You can test how good a guitar is with a stopwatch.
Can you?
Sure. A guitar that rings for 10 seconds is not as good as when it rings for 45 seconds. Would you agree with that?
I would agree
with
that.
And I'm sitting here when I'm going... If you're a guitar player and you're not interested in that, you're not a guitar player. That's really good because you're barely touching the string and all kinds of interesting things are coming out. So to me, we have done our job today.
I have one last question.
I didn't get to do a clinic here today because I got trumped
by, yes, unfortunately,
I'm Robin Ford.
I've got to say, do you know what? I
got trumped. Am I allowed to use that term in America anymore? Probably not. It now means something different.
You got trumped. Yeah, that's true. That's bad news. Well, look, so I normally wouldn't suggest that you guys go and shop in other stores, but you know what? Paul is over for it. We can't have Paul do an evening with Paul for us this year because the only day he was free, we'd already booked Robin Ford.
Yeah, well, first of all, Robin is musical royalty.
Yes.
He's an extraordinary musician, extraordinary human being, and not only does he play well, he writes well, he sings like a bird. You're lucky to have him. Congratulations getting him here. I hope all you guys show up.
Well, it's a sold out event. So if you aren't coming to the Robin Ford event and Paul is appearing at a place near you.
If you don't have a ticket to Robin Ford on a sold out event, you can get a scraggler from one of my events when you come to the country.
Honestly,
that's just great, no, Captain. Oh my God, you're going down in flames. What is Captain? Yeah, there's no water near here.
In the very, very first video that I ever did with Rob Chapman, who you met went at the NAMM show. Rob, we're walking around the store, and Rob said to me, you need a nickname. And I said, this is on camera. And I said, I don't have a nickname, Rob. You have to call me Lee. And he said, no, you're the captain of this fine ship. And that's it. It stuck.
I don't think that's where it came from. I think you walked in to sell a copier, and it said, look, Captain, I don't want your copier. Out!
Probably. Probably. No, I've been the captain. I was called much worse things when I was trying to sell photocopiers. Yeah. Yes, much worse. Look, I have to ask you one last question. You're probably sick of being asked it.
No.
But let me think about it. No. If I was ever going to download the Grindr app, it would be to try and hunt down this guy. Not that
me?
He would have the Grindr. No, no, no.
That's
I want to know. I want to know about.
Find me on the Grindr app.
No, no, no. You won't find you on the Grindr app.
That's great.
I want to know about John Mayer.
What about him?
I just love John Mayer.
What about him?
And I want to know.
Look, he's an extraordinary musician.
Yes.
I was in the studio with him. He was decent enough to invite me to a session at a place called East West in LA, and I'm positive that I was watching a hit song get recorded. And watching him do it was really something.
With the trio?
Yeah. And watching them learn the tune, watching them do the demos to beat it up, how they went through it, how they went and played live in the room when Pino was playing bass and Steve was playing drums. And forget all that. He's extraordinarily intelligent.
Yeah.
He's very, very good at trying to get wonderful tones out of an instrument and pushing me to do things I normally wouldn't do. And we got the nod to make the guitars for the Grateful Dead tour. And he needed a guitar that got that Garcia tone. And it's not well known how Garcia got that tone, because you can't really get a Garcia tone out of a normal guitar. Turns out it's the middle pickup.
Right.
Turns out that he was getting that sound out of a middle pickup, and it took us a long time to hone it in so that when John played live, and you know PAs make things way too bright and too bassy and the whole bit, that it didn't kind of sound like it, but it captured the vibe and the energy and the love of that music. And I think that we got a nod to do that. It was extraordinary. And, you know, that guitar is getting very well known, not just on YouTube, but in the world. And he played one of our NF3s with Clapton, and that's well known. And he's been playing a lot of PRS here recently, and was on Jimmy Kimmel the other night playing with the Dead & Company. And look, I think the world of John. I think he's a very, very high-level musician.
Yeah.
By the way, his singing on this record was spectacular.
Everything that I, yeah, I mean, of all the guitar players that influenced me and I listen to, you know, I think he's pretty much like the most complete. It's like, what can't he do? He just makes everything sound great. He's got a lovely voice. He understands songwriting. Yeah. None of it's too self-obsessed. You know, it's there's definitely an angle. He understands kind of. The purpose of a tune is to sort of engage with an audience and be that kind of interesting melody. But yeah, I'm so excited that the trio's back together, because for me, that was his, for me anyway, that was the pinnacle of
his
career.
If you take somebody like John, he's got all those qualities. Carlos Santana was on stage, he's playing the last guy in the last corner, delivering a melody when a guy's buying a beer, everybody's singing. I mean, hello, he's a stadium guitar player.
Yeah.
And a radio guitar player. It's second he comes on, everybody knows who it is.
Yeah.
Same thing with Mark Tremonti or Neil Sean, or, you know, there's a lot of musicians that carry these extraordinary qualities, right? Mm-hmm. So I don't want to make it out like John's the only musician alive, but I'm telling you, they all have different set of cards, and John's set of cards is really something.
So, and as far as the guitar that he's been playing, what's the future of that kind of in terms of people being able to buy that guitar? Or
if I tell you now what we're planning, I will have released it with you and not through my dealer network and not with my reps and not with my distributors, and you would know before Gavin, and that's just not fair. You can't trump the whole world. Did I use the word trump again? That's terrible.
Stop it. Say something. You can't Clinton the whole world, or you can't balance it up.
No, that you sound like an Englishman using American slang to curse. That's not going to work.
Well, why don't we, and this bit you have to edit out, why don't you then pretend to go and tell me? And then, of course, the video can just kind of like fuzz out as if there's been an intermission.
We'll be releasing that.
That kind of thing. So let's do that bit again. But don't really tell me. Just start
to
tell me.
He just got it. I don't have to repeat that. That was perfect. Did I do that well?
No, say no.
We'll be releasing the John. I'm not telling you crap. No.
Damn it.
Y'all ain't gonna hear today, boy. It ain't gonna happen. This shit ain't going down today, boy.
I don't even understand what Paul's talking about anymore. I think Paul needs more coffee and a cake. Well, look, I tell you what. You know I stole your shirt?
Yeah.
I know this is like nothing like as expensive as the one you gave me. But would you like one of these? I got you one of these.
Look. I would love one.
Do you like that?
I would love one.
There you are.
Thank you very much.
You're very welcome.
Looks very much like a Jack Daniel's shirt.
Shh, we're not allowed to say that. They nearly got sued last year for it looking a bit like that, so don't say
it's
that. It doesn't look anything like a Jack Daniel's shirt.
Just play some blues, will you?
Okay.
Show me where you're playing, because that sounded great, dude.
I'm just like...
All minor. All right. You go.
Thank you.